Screen Actors, this video is about how to become an actor. What exactly does it take for you to become an actor and be really successful at it? The answer may surprise you and inspire you. I'm Louis DiBianco and this is my channel, Screen Acting Success. This is where you come every Friday for more tips, techniques, and secrets to help you become a compelling, working screen actor in demand. If this is your first time here, click subscribe and give the video a thumbs up. Stick around to the end because I'm giving away free training that you are not going to want to miss. What does it take to be an actor? Well, there seems to be a consensus about three things that people have to have to be actors and successful at it. Number one, talent. But what is talent? Is it something that people are born with? Is there a talent gene that lives somewhere in your body? Or can anyone who doesn't demonstrate talent develop it? We're going to find out in this video and talk a bit about what I call the myth of talent. The second thing that people say you've got to have is a certain look. There's a certain attractive look, beauty, handsomeness. Problem is, those things are so subjective and they change consistently. Right now in society, 2021, there's a massive upheaval in how we see people and what we consider to be attractive. In the Hollywood system of yesteryear, people like Cary Grant and Gregory Peck were considered the only kind of guys who could be leading men. And we had women like Marilyn Monroe and Grace Kelly. Fortunately, people like Dustin Hoffman, who is short, got to be a leading man in 1967 in The Graduate. And today we see people like Paul Giamatti, who looks like an everyman. If you saw him on the street and he wasn't an actor, you would not even recognize him and you forget his face quickly. He is a leading man and that's good for everybody. Women, well, what about people like Frances McDormand? Brilliant actress, not traditionally good looking. Renee Zellweger is another one. Do you know how many people were told in Hollywood that, well, you're just not good looking to be on screen? I believe that even Clint Eastwood was told, yeah, some producer way back when said, you know what, your Adam's apple is too big. Clint Eastwood, not good looking enough? And women are constantly told, like Meryl Streep was told, you're not pretty enough. Do you know who Carrie Ann Moss is? She starred in The Matrix. I worked with Carrie Ann Moss twice in Toronto. And on one show that she was on, a television series, a producer didn't want her because he said she wasn't pretty enough. Luckily, the star of that show, Nick Mancuso, insisted that she was. She got on the show. Then when she went to Hollywood, really, she wasn't pretty enough? She was the leading woman in The Matrix. So looks are totally subjective. What about your looks? Do people tell you or do you tell yourself, I don't have what it looks like to be on screen? And then the third thing is training. There's a consensus that, oh yeah, you've got to have training. You've got to go to acting school, take acting classes if you're going to be an actor. And then there's the question about which technique is the one that you've got to learn, especially for the camera. I mean, we have method acting, the Actor's Studio, that's Lee Strasberg, Meisner technique, and Stella Adler, who broke off from the studio system and created her own style of acting training. Well, is it possible that there's also a cult around acting training? And the teachers need us to believe that it's absolutely essential and without it you can't succeed. Hey, I'm not knocking training. I've had training. I'm an acting teacher. But I want you to think about, do you have to have it in order to succeed? Well, what about people like Tom Cruise? Not trained. Johnny Depp? Not trained. Meg Ryan, not trained. Charlize Theron, her story's great. She was struggling and couldn't make ends meet in Hollywood. She went to a bank one day to cash an out-of-state check, and the teller said, "You can't." She lost it, got into an argument with him. Well, a talent agent saw her and loved the quality he saw in her arguing. The rest is history. He approached her. She became an actress and a star. So all of those three things kind of fall apart because they're based on people's strong opinions. So if they're not the things that you absolutely must have, is there one thing that you gotta have if you're gonna be an actor and succeed? Yes, let's call it the X factor. And that X factor is burning desire. Now, I'm not talking about, oh, I really wanna be an actor. It's gotta be stronger than that. It's gotta be, if I don't get this, if I don't make it, I'll die. It's life and death. It's got to be that strong. And that leads me to this. If you want proof that you need desire above all else, which is going to change your beliefs, think about this. Anyone, absolutely anyone, can act, and everyone is acting all the time. The difference between the people who never consider getting in front of a camera and those who do is that those who are not actors are acting unconsciously. They're allowing their thoughts and feelings to transform their characters so that they play the roles in society of either the victim, the hero, the stud, the bad boy, the bad girl, the nice girl, the geek, etc. All of those are made-up stories based on images that you choose to identify with in your mind. If you want to really check this out for yourself, well, look at how your body language changes depending on your strong feelings. If you're sad, you tend to not carry yourself high. You tend to slump over a bit. Your shoulders tend to become rounded. Your head tends to look down. You don't look people, meet their eyes directly. That's a character that you're playing. And you can change it by changing what's inside. There was a wonderful, really imaginative casting director named Michael Sherpleff. And if you haven't read his book, Audition, get it. It's not just about auditioning. It's truly a deep dive into what acting is all about, especially acting for the camera. Michael Sherpleff was the casting director who saw Dustin Hoffman, and although Dustin was short, he wasn't a strong leading man type of the day. He wasn't athletic. He wasn't the all-American jock, and that's what the producers wanted for The Graduate. He knew that Dustin Hoffman had the right quality for that role. He insisted on it. He got the producers and the director, Mike Nichols, to look at Hoffman. The rest is history. Not only was Hoffman great in it, it launched his career. And it changed, again, what we considered the look of a leading man on screen. It really does go back to what you will choose to believe about yourself. And if your desire is not strong enough, it's too easy for you to give in to those beliefs, that mind chatter that says, look, who am I kidding? I don't look glamorous. I don't look handsome. I don't have this or that or whatever. And you just settle for less. Sherpleff made a great statement. He said he's constantly asked, hey, well, should I continue or should I even decide to be an actor? He always gives the same answer. He says, you know what? If you have a choice to be anything else, then by all means choose to be that something else. People are, what? He says, yeah, you know why? Because to be an actor, you've got to be a person who is so hooked on it. He calls it that they are so diseased that they can't be cured of the disease to become an actor. It's such a deep need in them that they've got to have it or die. So it goes back to what I said before. It's burning desire. By the way, if you need, you want to remember after you've seen this video, the three things that everybody says you're supposed to have and that you can't live without if you want to be famous, if you want to be an actor and be successful. The talent, looks, and training. TLT. Use this silly acronym. Tough luck, toots. See, you won't forget that because it's funny. It's weird. And then when you say, what does that mean? Well, T for talent, L for looks, and T for training. Some other interesting notes about who can be an actor without training. How about a guy like Danny Trejo? Some of you may not know who he is. Here he is on screen. This guy is a street guy. He's an ex-convict. And what he learned in prison about human behavior and character, and combined that with his looks, plus his confidence, made him a candidate for the big screen. And he is a very popular, in-demand character actor today. Anyone can do it. Do you want it badly enough? If you got value from this, definitely leave a comment below so that other people can be inspired and more people can see this video. Also, I promised you some free training. On the screen is an image of the ebook that I wrote. It's a 21-page detailed guide, everything on acting tips to how to light yourself, what to do to get the best sound. I give you a complete breakdown of the gear that I use, even a full diagram of the studio setup that I use, which you can duplicate if you want to. You'll find a link to that below. Download it, apply it, and start doing brilliant self-tapes. You'll also find a link below to my latest online course, Self-Taping Mastery. That takes a deeper dive into self-taping. Plus, I am there in every module holding you by the hand, guiding you step by step, and you get the opportunity to reach out to me with questions, which I will definitely answer for you. Plus, you'll see when you click the link that I'm offering bonuses, including a course on live auditions online, which I charge $199 for. I'm throwing that in as a gift if you enroll in Self-Taping Mastery. Check it out. If you decide it's for you, I'll have the opportunity to get to know you better and be your guide to greater success. If it's not for you, definitely get the book and use everything in it to advance your career. I always like to end with this reminder about the nature of screen acting. Actors make too much about dialogue. Will I remember or forget my lines? Relax. The lines are not as important as the inner life between them, what's underneath the lines and what's in between them. So whenever you have a script in your hand, especially for auditions, always feel it first, then say it. If you feel it and then say it, you'll mean it. If you feel it, say it and mean it, chances are you'll book it. Go out, create a stellar on-camera career for yourself, and please let me know about it so I can celebrate with you and share it with the world.